Hello, my amazing people. I greet you according to your time. If it is your first time and you like what we are doing here, kindly subscribe. Put on your notification bell to all notifications. It's very, very important because it will enable you to know when we upload a new video. Here we react to all forms of videos. We educate, we inform the members of the public about what is happening. And to you, YouTube, I appreciate you for creating this wonderful platform that we are using to disseminate information. At the same time, I put a disclaimer that here in Linda's TV show, we do not promote violence, we do not promote hate speech, we do not promote misleading information. Rather, we are here to educate, inform the members of the public, and also to remind YouTube that a call for self-determination is never a call for war. Every country in the world have this.
Adema, actually, I'm an update about Inhe Basara Kilamberi. Of course, so delay some people, how near threat to them. All the less of people had a threat room, can hammer me a call off an ala. Ubua, all say, but one na call a threat to the one. A cannot bomb market, so we cannot bomb market, in doing so, Bunagamia, and up where market. Ejicham facts, threatening no worse, yana voice note, any engineer here. Some boggy seat, I get washed and boggy you, you know. Now, and then on this one, Bequen, Wokano, nde hono datin, Wokano, nde my here. How de la cool? Na Kilamberi wo onye bera chuo ndi ojo oso ni zombe na wo onye bera me ka enwe security na obodo ha. I am not against Kilamberi itu ndi ojo oso ni zombe watakwa na ebe m neje ihe ndi against wo Kilamberi na ndi otu ye ibu ndi mmadu aka ha di ocha oburu na Kilamberi ibu wendo oshi ni zombe. Government is here, buendoshi, buende kidnappers, buende this and that. Mune, yamewiye. Yamewiye o. Ebe mu abuchi non soba non son kwa. Oji soche protect the week international foundation who de against the wo Kilamberi. Ibu, mo wunde vigilante ye. Ibu nde akaha di ocha. Kaba hudiri ibu oge. Let me play this, the voice note. We have evidences like I told you, but they are claiming. They were evidence. And when you hear the other hand, they can't play a good voice no longer. It's too very long. But I'll be calling you again. And I'm going to get this video. And I'll be going to get this video. Onye iga nu voice yao. Munye. Onye buru die. Munye. Onye Kilamberi buru die. And I can my play chaya now. So that you will know where we are coming from. Oh, we're going to get this by Sabia. One boy. I see them making boom. No haji. Ndeka si by Sabia. Not if he said any 2 days ago. You know, we take away our petition. They have been following it up, but when he has got the petition. So, when we say there is something fishy and something is smelling. I am not going to tell you. We are not against Kilamberi, Ibu Ndoshi, Ibu Ndi kidnap and Izombe, Ichu Honso. We are not against it. Or emma. Ihe mu wa uchi non so bad against it. Ibu Ndi aka had your child. That is why I'm fighting. So, mandine yegu, mandine eklem, yan eklemo. Let me play this voice note first. Kunu gote ba ina eje. Na bora anokata awu he akuru asida an ehuna asida no. You know? So the candidate threat, you know, your threatening will not work. Adema, can I play go this voice note first?
Hello.
Hello. Hello,
woman.
Ando, good afternoon.
No, no, so kwa na po.
Okay, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon,
Adam Mumasa.
I'm investigation. I know name. You go?
Yes, sir.
Somebody send the channel more number and a picture, digi.
Yes, sir.
But actually, I'm good from you. You go? Before we can now conclude the end of the mega.
Okay, sir.
Yes. You want to talk to Lamberi Anwa?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Not only medical.
Okay, yeah, I'm around August 10th, last few 2 years, 2022.
Okay.
So, I got all, although I'm going to threat Ghana, I'm going to go to the ambassador before.
Maybe?
Ambassador, one ambassador got crate and CP crate, one bit of this SCM, this IPOP mede Bugesin de Mata Nimo State.
Okay, so Johnny has a role on that.
Yes, due to Karata and Arura Aladichi, all these killing innocent people.
Yes, yes.
There are six is inspector. Nania was the sergeant that time.
Okay.
So Yana like Kana Iruberi Yisi. We open a hot hammy. High mayor, which is a demon who don't
you know, Ndeke and Opa?
Yes, yes. So, Hapuze, Oga Puzerun, Achieze has stand by Nimo State for, Hano stand by 2 months or 3 months. Before the CP, Abia transfer her to that special duty, Hagan Ibima. Hano that special duty for 6 months. That's the same Kilamberi, Popota Hiba. So happy I'm not anymore no we're at headquarters for 4 months before that criticism had that new anti-vice.
Mm-hmm.
Because that anti-vice they made you before.
Yes.
From there, this killer threat said him. So now they will put the animal state. Now they will put it on a lot. So dim no way. Or the way I want someone at Tilaberry. Threats Garia. No way here and the age. No threat now. What a problem here, mom? No, I cannot marry secret. I don't know.
Exactly.
I don't know nothing.
All
because of that. That's right from that ambassador.
Okay, and
yes. So, happen. Before the CP, I got transfer her to. Yeah, that special duty had an Ibima.
Mm-hmm.
Hanor, that special duty for 6 months. That the same Kilamberi, Popota Hiba. So, happy Hanor Nimo, no, we're in the headquarters for 4 months. Before that, criticism had that new anti vice. Because that anti vice, they met you before.
Yes.
From there, this Kilamberi threatened him. So, now they will put the animal state. No, they will pray on Allah. So, dim no way. Or the way I want someone at Tilaberry. Threats, Garia. No way, yeah, the age. No, not threats, yeah, now. What a problem, yeah, mom. No, I cannot marry secret. I don't know.
No, we didn't hear, exactly.
I don't know nothing. No way, you marry, yeah, all because of that. That's right from that ambassador.
Okay, and the dig on about his
exactly. Yes. Yeah. That's so. We want anything, Omeria. So my boy is saying, "When he had the deposition, he has some more happy body and a killer very good brain we born. Obu no majoria. Ye they don't no ye boy. Obu no majoria. Keyo get gloria for. More happy, more happier. Man, I go cry every time. A deposition, deposition against that man. Okweho. Imu mumoke na.
Yes.
That fateful day. On 10th August 2022. So, Yage Chebria. Chebria na that Ejemekuru Road. But, Dimu, Oduka, Hakmoria, maybe you own the arrangement.
Okay.
Because Jema Dimu got all information, Kaji, Gandhi, and Hassel Goros, and Hakmor had this record. So, Hagazi, the man is Oweziana Azan with Moto. So we see an answer with Moto Hagan Yellow Road at Junction, that is Ejemekuru Junction. So all the driver who had a Biogwaga could get this thing.
Yes.
In my police saga Hapotana, exactly. Because thank God my driver was a civilian.
Okay.
He witnessed everything.
Okay.
So across road, so Dima has okay, see I am the person of Poga. Depends on Poriana, non Bayana Hagazi, Kenya, Tona, Kahapuazi, Kalachiwaz, Tona on a ton, then Kilamberi, Namuka, Flasha, block her road. So Dima wa one inspector, no Nako Kosaya Budi, Gagwa, that man, not that man, Obuzo, because Oga Guzeze, Niru Dimoto, Flash Okia.
Okay, Tami Haneme.
He had between 9. Ndabani.
Okay.
Na because money have put around 8:30. Because oru 1 hour yeah, me. Because after before 8-9 o'clock, that be the power line here. Line here, yeah, the ring go in a pick here. So yeah, flash yeah, all come. Yes, the colleague yeah, good day, Mara. So that guy yeah, she had a couple. So the guy yeah, good day, not only room to go. Yeah, pose yeah, how can he flash to come mark the particular place demon no? Because people know he a mega attack. No, that boy called Karibu.
Okay.
But he didn't remove that boy or to he all focus on the boy on demon.
Because I confirm Ronald killer Berry won ya.
Yes. Because the driver, he might be the bar, Obi Oba we bar. The driver ndozo the police also bacha also. On an driver. Being on the driver trying to rescue my husband. There's no way. They buy him with a car. Iomir, Ieshina, Niamota, now that driver's Bazeni me, Okurumoto. Now if Okurumoto are gone, so you know which, and maybe not the no one with the driver.
Okay.
You know, Bazen, Imo, Yakwa, can make sure that the driver walla.
Okay.
So the driver on Okurumoto are witness everything that happened.
So,
the only thing is that in the record, I'm at that time, I'm very shocked. Now.
Yes.
So, in the record, the record, record, the driver interview, maybe even the drivers, many times, they open the case. No. They got employer and orgasm.
Okay, so the driver will be ready to testify.
Yes, also, Bob, no, no.
Thank you.
So, he will write it, send for them.
Thank you. Come back. When the case is there, maybe he had from here confession of the driver. When the case is there, I could declare CP, IGP, or AIG. When
there more petition. Yeah, I mean, that time, yeah, I mean, because I disguised myself as a police woman.
Okay.
I'm a Kahamata Nambu police.
Okay.
So I wrote petition. I wrote a petition. I sit on top of the petition. I'm a petition. My echo one company. Okay. Many people they repetition.
Okay.
Because the thing gas were Benin. They petition, the IG, the former IG sit on top of the petition, the CP sit on top of the petition. Now Baramba, some more as a police woman, I wrote petition against the CP, against the man. Can't I wait first as a CP? But I don't know that my work is at risk. Masaya. I just as my say I'm gonna read that petition. Say na no one di yamuro go get you the petition. If they write petition, let them face the petition. And let them face the case. And I have a name and press. No, and I have name and face. No, are you all the CP? You all the CP. My say I cannot because na unwere go governor Chorinye na me a daily petition against the CP and the man. And they can't give them remove my name. Messiah, I don't beg anybody to give me any money. We want him in a cold blood. Sorry. I can never eat that money because it's a blood money go to the treasure. If I see the money, the treasure, I can't eat it. No more ESM, Brazil. Oh no, no government, Brazil. Yes. Mama, yes. Yes. Follow police.
Follow police officers.
They didn't arrest him. They didn't put him for sale within 24 hours.
Oh.
He had one of them. Why would you take petition? Why would you? Now they can't give me money. They don't take anybody for money. If you people are killing to give other people money, Ngozi, I'm not in support of that. I can never collect it because it's a blood money.
Oh, God.
It's a blood money. I'm telling you, so the case, even people had been helping me. Even one man from Abuja, I don't know the man. He take up the case, but they bench it. He sit on top of the case.
Aye.
this my husband, Oga, because I've run away. I said, some of my should not worry. Now, about Nani Dimo could threaten them. No, threatening many people. If we are away, not the threats near. I should not worry. Now, I'll get your marker.
Will you be ready? Will you be? Because almost also in KDG, one with other people, we have documented the end of Mariotago.
Yes, sir.
We got the quality. Aurona, I need push with this thing. The bob last again, Potabia, Yaputabia, Zarono.
I'm a Potan, yes, or Timo Kobo.
Thank you.
To avenge the death of my husband.
Chai. Thank you, my
old.
I'll be calling you as this thing progresses, you know.
Okay, so bad, sir, no?
Okay.
Odeba, the voice of the woman onye police eburu die e boka no nyane ebo no onye eburu die onye gboburu die wo Kilamberi. We will keep investigating and progressing. I will keep playing, bringing out other evidences. Na agada kwe ebe nde si na hawo nde na akwado Kilamberi no zina threat no so nkwa. Na threat no no so because no so is now ready to bring this guy to justice. Ekwole mie, anya si hu Kilamberi ebukwele ndoshi. Anya si hu Kilamberi ebukwele nde kidnapper. Nha yi na Kilamberi. If you touch any innocent person aka, you will pay. That is what we are saying. Ehona ndoshi nda ma nde kidnapper bobo tigbo Kilamberi nwete ha, chabishi aha olu, chabishi aha aka, gbarie ha. Man, he touch Hana, any innocent man, any innocent woman, in the course of him again, no Haji Obama and his own bed. Kilamberi, you must pay. It's a promise. Happen when they sponsor again, and asking nothing will happen. When it will happen, haga boso. Osu, ndan sponsor again, gaboso. I am promising you that. Awe he makashi anya ne makashi ono. Like I told you, ihunoromroga. Chukwo kika bi ama dilem romia. So be very careful. When I will end up now, they threaten them. You have to open your eyes before you open. Because at the end of the day, the day of reckoning must surely come. We will continue to bring you evidences as this issue progresses.
Authority and the violence that seems to have erupted in the southeast.
Well, what we are seeing in the southeast is synchronized violence, synchronized by certain people. Definitely not by Igbos.
Okay.
Those people who are doing that are foreigners. If you see a group of Igbo people moving, from their physiognomy, you will know. Now, one of the things that people did in the southeast was to get close to them, speak Igbo to them, and without exception, they responded in broken English. And you saw the other man speaking on Sunday, being displayed by the police as the only surviving person among those who attended to burn the prisons again. The man was given an Igbo name. And when he spoke, he had a northern accent. But back to your question about what is really happening. In the past 2 years or more, the clamor for a president of Nigeria coming from the southeast has been on. And if you notice, up to the past 3 months, there was no problem in the southeast, 4 months. What happened? Suddenly, if you read some papers published in Abuja, you see Igbos are killing northerners. You call those in the south, they say, what are you talking about? It has nothing to do with any Igbo man or any northerner. What we are witnessing is a programmed action by some people to destabilize the southeast, indeed the whole of Igbo land, with a message, Igbo land is unstable. If you're unstable, how then can you produce a president? That is the real key in issue. The herdsmen have always been there. But if you notice, for the past 3 or 4 months, issue of the herdsmen had died down. Except in Ebonyi State, where up to last Sunday, the herdsmen were still killing people.
But we cannot deny the fact that these destruction and arson attacks are taking place in the southeast region on security formations, on electoral body INEC offices, and of course killing of the security officials themselves. So the question is, how does this make a call or a point for an argument for inclusion. If you say marginalization and inequity has been, you know, the reason for this clamor, and some would say for the clamor of cessation, how do these arson attacks and killings and destruction make a point for inclusion? And who stands to benefit from these attacks? Why have they not gone? Why do they continue to recur, in your opinion?
First correction is this. Who is doing the destruction?
Exactly.
Who is attacking police formations? Who is attacking the INEC? If you notice the targets, election conducting body, security body. In the first place, Igbos are not destroyers. Igbos are builders. Since the end of the war, the federal government has not been building police stations in the Igbo land. Every structure you see there, apart from the old prisons in the world, which was built in the 1950s, is the result of the contribution of people. I'll give you an example. I come from a human but not local government of Imo State. Recently, the police divisional quarters was destroyed, I think 2 or 3 weeks ago. What most people don't know is that building was built by the community, also community, and donated to the police last December. So why will the people who built turn around to destroy? For what purpose? The average Igbo man knows that those who are doing the destroying are not Igbos. The special squad of security men sent by federal government are also not Igbos.
Okay.
So it's a case of the policemen will come shoot into the air, stray bullet will land on people. And then the unknown gunmen will move around in brand new Hilux trucks. Shoot into the air, with faces covered. Once in a while, people will get close and do like this, and then they take a closer look at them.
So if you say the Igbos are not destroying, who then is carrying out these attacks?
The unknown gunmen. It is not by accident that they call them unknown gunmen. That's why I said, if you go to Alaba today, you know there's an Igbo section. If you see there, from the physiognomy, you say these are Igbos. If you turn towards the right, you see Alaba Rago. That's where the Hausa traders are. You also see their physiognomy. If I go to Jankara Market here in Lagos, you don't need to be told these are Yorubas. So if the unknown gunmen cover their faces, once in a while, people go, they speak Igbo to them. Sing a Igbo, they wouldn't even respond.
This is quite a strong...
It is a strong revelation.
Yeah.
But the biggest problem they have now in Igbo land is that if they see somebody of my age, they will go after me. Police will arrest me and call me a financier. If they see my son, they will grab him and say he's an activist. Send him to the police station, military barracks or anywhere. You have to run around to get him out. And you know what it means to Nigeria for someone to run around. I don't mean real race. You have to do something. Otherwise, you see him on TV the next day confessing to things he did not do. Because when they torture you, you have no option. And remember, Archbishop Obinna, the Archbishop of the Catholic Diocese, last Sunday came out almost weeping that the morgue where they keep dead bodies, that place is overflowing, 35 unidentified bodies. The Nigerian Bar Association came out and said, we have set up a unit to liaise with the police commission. That's how they have been able to rescue some people, including the man who came from Bayelsa, who was going to buy a casket for his father-in-law's burial. The man was grabbed and displayed on TV as the high-ranking chief.
Permit me to just interject, because you're making strong assertions, and we wonder why this hasn't come to light in a more public forum. But let me just ask, what we do know, though, is that there was this, I'm glad you said you're from Imo State.
Yes.
There was a sit-at-home order, and it would seem that largely it was obeyed. So that would then beg the question, who is in charge? You know, we want to bring up the issue of IPOB because they've made certain assertions. And then we want to ask the question as well regarding Imo State. It's hard to put this. There have been assertions by people in Imo State that since the current governor came into being, that Imo State hasn't known peace. So suggesting that his coming in as governor has also triggered some of this violent attacks. What's your take on that?
Let me take them one by one. Issue of sit at home. To observe a day for our departed brothers, those who died during the war, has been on since 1970. So it depends on the government of to make it a focal point.
No, I'm talking about how it was enforced. There was intimidation behind it.
No, there was no intimidation. Listen, what you saw was what we call a charade. Some people wear black and red and be moving around. You think they're Igbos, they're not Igbos. That's the point I was making. The unknown gunmen are not Igbos. As for day of mourning, it's observed every year. You have seen the one of 30. September 9th, some people will also observe their own. They don't make noise about it. The Jews call their own Yom Kippur. We call our own mourning our dead. Two, IPOB is what I call a phenomenon that has risen because of injustice, because of lack of fair playing ground, because of errant discrimination. Now, nature abhors vacuum. So whenever there is this kind of lack of inclusiveness, grumbling will come in. All it takes is somebody to harvest that they are grumbling and say, this man is doing something bad. Let's see what I can do. Believe me, the average person will join. Mm. On the issue of the governor, I better leave it at that. Is the governor in charge of any security force there? No. If he says something negative, they'll go against him. You know where he lives in Owerri? It's called the fortress. On one side is army chief's house, police chief, DSS, Air Force. All of them live in a circle. And the police headquarters and the prisons that were just burned down, just opposite them.
Okay.
CCTV showed all those who do the attacking. Do you know that till today, none of these groups I mentioned ever produced that CCTV?
I mean, a lot of people watch will be wondering, why is nobody being brought to book? Where are the perpetrators? But in the absence of state police, we've seen vigilantes across the country, states having to form their own vigilantes, and as well as regional security, same as the Southeast with Ebube Agu. They don't seem to be making much headway. What have the governors got wrong when it comes to security of their states and, of course, the region, Southeast in particular now?
Well, I don't want to call it intimidation from Abuja. I also don't want to call it timidity of the governors. No. Let me say it's a case of three political parties having governors in the Southeast. Three political PDP has two. That's Enugu and Abia. Enugu has always had a Bago. They have a name for their own, and they have bosses for them. Abia State, yes, its own is not as elaborate as that of Enugu. Imo State also passed a law a long time ago outlawing open grazing, and they also passed a law establishing Ibubago. But then the governor said he has sent some people to train the military barracks in Anambra State so that when they come, they form the nucleus. Now, the man in Anambra also has his own. His own method is different because there are three parties. They have different methods. Abga said, okay, if you kill a cow, you pay. If you kill a human being, you pay. And they're enforcing it. So when they're talking of a bag to them, they may say, we have something different. The man in Ebo, you know, he has just joined APC. Mm-hmm. And he's also the chairman, so he's been drawn on one side. Unfortunately, his state is the worst hit by the killer henchmen. Up till this Sunday, they were still killing. Now, the governors are also, well, I think they're handicapped. But remember this, there are killings all over the country, in all the zones. And in terms of number, in terms of statistics, Kaduna State has had more people killed or kidnapped than the whole of Southeast and South put together. Mm. Yeah, the IG of police, when he came, he said, I'm concentrating on Southeast and South. In other words, they know what they're doing. So those special squads sent to Imo State because of this crisis, are they putting anything together? Their job is to go and block the road. I saw them. I was there Saturday before last. For me to pass, all the roads were blocked in the city. For me to go to the airport, I had to call one man. When I noticed his less unfriendly appearance, I said, I just joked. He said he was an Asian man. I said, Asian, why you? He laughed. He said, I said, okay, Oba, talk where he said, relax. He said, Oga, pass. That's how I was able to go to the airport. The next day, Sunday, Golak was killed. The insecurity there is there, but it's artificial.
You seem to be blaming, everyone else, particularly the federal government, except for those in the region.
Because we are not destroyers. The average Igbo man is a builder. That over airport was built, started by this Ambaku, which people contributed one naira. Everything you have in Imo State was built by the people, not by the government.
Okay, let me just bring this in.
Thank you so much for sticking to this video to the end. Like I said before, now it's time for us to go to the comment section to air our mind and our opinion. Say what you think about this video and this platform. Do it constructively. Share this video, like, subscribe, and also continue to watch Linda's TV show, because this is the home of news. Until I see you again in my next video, remain blessed. For now, I would say bye-bye.